I would like to confirm that since I went to Washington, that I've engaged the White House officials, I have engaged the State Department officials, I have engaged members of the Senate, I have engaged members of the House of Representatives, I have engaged business people, I have engaged American citizens themselves, and my message has been very simple, that we require them to lift the adverse travel advisories that they have issued against Kenya. And the reason is not that to receive a lot of American tourists, but this has a domino effect. The moment US issues a travel advisory, other countries follow suit. Basically, those travel advisories are for the benefits of the civil servants. It's for them to safeguard their career and their reputation, in the sense they say, if should something happen to an American and there's no travel advisory, then that American can sue their government. So it's really to protect their back. And in my view, we should just ignore them. In fact, what they told me is that they have got travel advisories against 83 countries in the world. So Kenya is not just the only one. The only difference they told me is this, that whereas they regret the consequences and the damage that it has done to our tourism, they say the difference between Kenya and other countries, they say that it is your media, meaning Kenyan media, that goes to their website, uploads the contents, and then splashes them on the front page in our newspapers. And when they do that, the other now foreign medias now pick it up from there. So it says we are our own worst enemy. If we just ignore them, very few people go to the website to read. If we just ignore them, nobody would even know. And it would not have the disastrous consequences it has on our tourism. So my appeal is, just ignore it. So to offer us this is the message we like now, us in Kenya to be giving out to the outside world. How beautiful this country is. How peaceful this country is. And when we say peaceful, we don't mean that there'll be no incidences of insecurity. They will be there, and they're always there in every country. Recently, who would have thought that terrorism would go to Paris? But the question you ask yourself, how come that no travel advisory was issued by the other countries? Proposing that you don't travel to Paris, nothing. So again, you can also see there's also discrimination. There has been bombing in London, underground, and the buses. No travel advisory was issued for us now to sell our country. We should not wash our dirty linen in public, because what you report is what is reported by other media. They pick it from there. In Washington, I'm trying very much to bring American tourists here to Kenya. I'm bringing a lot of trade delegations. I had one in December. There's one coming in May, another in October, another one in November. So there's interest. There's interest. For the first time, Americans are going to the map and looking at where Kenya is. I'm trying to bring Americans here to Kenya. I'm trying to see whether Kenya Airways can have direct landing rights in the US. Because again, for the American going on vacation, they don't like connecting flights. Because they say, I've taken a vacation for 2 or 3 days. So if I'm going to stay in a place where I'm connecting for 6 hours, I've already lost 6 hours of my holiday. So they want a direct flight. They only go to holidays where there is a direct flight. That's their nature. So we have to see how we can adopt, how we can adapt that to our advantage. So I'm trying to get Kenyans to get direct landing rights, so that at least the American tourists can come directly from America to Kenya. I want American tourists to come here. I want American business people to come here. I want American corporations to set up their headquarters here in Kenya. I've been talks with the boy, told them, look, you need to put up your regional headquarters here in Africa. Kenya Airways is your biggest customer in Africa.